Do you have any communication tools, strategies that you use and that you found effective when discussing genomic testing with patients?
There are many communication strategies that can be useful, and I think it's not a one-size-fits-all approach.
Absolutely find out what the patient knows already, because you can be dealing with people that have quite significant learning disability through to professors of molecular biology. So the first thing is check what prior knowledge is and talk to the patient first, so you kind of get a sense of the level of information that they require.
It's very helpful to get cues from the patient and mirror their language so that you can frame things in a way that is meaningful to them. Also understanding their values and their understanding of the condition so we can pitch it at the right level.
There's loads and loads of analogies that you can use. I have a tendency to keep things really, really simple.
So try to keep the language as simple as possible, because I think what might be familiar to us is often very unfamiliar to patients.
You know, the classic analogy is thinking about the genome as a kind of library and, you know, with shelves, and our genes are books on those shelves, and we read those books to look for a spelling mistake which might stop the body from being able to read that book properly.
You're best to pick an analogy and go with it and keep it simple. Using lots of different analogies tends to be very confusing for people and just becomes very abstract. So important to choose what works for you and go with it, and then just to watch your language about it, so to try and avoid lots of medical jargon and to try and avoid any terms that feel really loaded. So one that I really don't like is faulty gene, because it describes something that's wrong, and actually what we're really talking about here is variation and difference between people.
I think consent for a genomic test, it's not something you can do in a minute or two sitting with the patient, talking to them about the implications of that test, explain the different possible results. How would it impact on them as an individual and on their family? They might be very different. And I also try to ask them about, you know, what their families, you know, what they feel, how they feel their family might take this information on board. You know, do they feel that they might struggle with it, or do you think that they would be comfortable with the discussion? If a person's uncertain as to whether or not they want to proceed, then it's fine. There's no rush. Often it's not going to impact over the matter of a few weeks on their care. So, you know, they can have an opportunity to go away, have a think about things, and we can see them again in a few months. And then they can make a decision after having an opportunity to discuss some of these things that they may never really have considered before.